Hey.
Yes, sir?
Ada?
Are you ready to install the radar beacon?
Does it have to be you? I could install it on a different robot.
My memory contains more relevant knowledge than any new robot you attempt to create. I appreciate your concern, but I can assure you I won't suffer any harm from the installation. So, are you ready?
It's time. Let's do this.
Good. The installation should be simple. Once I'm in the robot workbench, just install the radar beacon and I'll do the rest. It's always fascinating watching you create.
Hey.
How may I be of service?
Hey, Ada.
A moment. The modification was successful. New hardware has been detected and software is updating. And installation complete. Analyzing mechanist hardware. The radar beacon is receiving a strong encrypted signal, but I can't determine the source.
Do you think the mechanist knows we're tampering with the beacon?
I've already added failsafes to ensure my location is secure and prevent any unintended commands the signal may issue. Unfortunately, one of that will help us determine the signal's source.
It's a good start, at least.
Absolutely. With some additional assistance, I should be able to decrypt the signal and locate the mechanist. Fortunately, I'm detecting another robo-brain in the Commonwealth that's receiving the same signal.
Which means the one I destroyed isn't the only robo-brain under mechanist control.
Yes, and we can use this to our advantage. The encryption on the source signal is complex, but not beyond solving. If you can bring me two additional beacons, they should provide the keys and algorithms that I need to enhance my decryption routines.
Are you sure this'll work?
I've calculated a 96.9% chance of success. Given your capabilities, I believe the odds to be in our favor.
Alright, let's do it.
Good. Let's get started. I'm uploading the location of the RoboBrain to your Pip-Boy now. Just be careful. These robots tend to travel in groups, so you're likely to encounter heavy resistance.
I Ada. One slightly dented but still functional radar beacon.
This will do nicely. And with any luck, it'll help us trace the mechanist's signal.
Remind me how this beacon will get us closer to tracing the mechanist's signal?
Each RoboBrain's radar beacon has unique encryption so that it can't be traced back to the source. However, acquiring two additional beacons should provide me with enough data to break the code. So if my theory is correct, this beacon will help us trace the mechanist's signal.
Don't worry. I'm sure it'll do the trick.
I certainly hope so. I'm going to begin my decryption routine, but it could take a while. In the meantime, I've picked up another RoboBrain beacon signal. It should be the last one you'll need to collect.
Good work, Ada.
Thank you. If my calculations are correct, the signal is coming from... Oh, this isn't good. Location confirmed. The RoboBrain is at Fort Hagen Satellite Array, which means it's in the hands of the Rust Devils.
Who or what are the Rust Devils?
Allow me to explain. My old caravan encountered them once while crossing the river into the city. The Rust Devils are a group of ruthless raiders who utilize robots for their nefarious practices. They scour the Commonwealth looking for my kind. What they can't capture and reprogram, they strip for spare parts. I realize they pose a greater threat to me than you. I just want you to be well informed. That being said, despite what lies ahead, I can easily continue to decrypt the signal as we proceed. So shall we be on our way? Something. Need any components? I have some to spare. Did you hear that? can I do for you?
Over there.
Certainly.
Hold.
Very well. I'll remain here.
Heads up. Come on.
How may I be of service?
Stay there.
I'd rather accompany you, but it's your decision. Understood. Please be careful, sir.
Excellent.
Make sure you don't leave anything useful behind. must apologize for the odd noises I'm currently emitting. A consequence of being mechanical in nature.
Hey.
I'd be happy to help if
Wait
I can.
Wait there.
You don't look like one of the Rust Devils. What are you doing here?
Hunting down a radar beacon.
A radar beacon? How very interesting. That's a very specific part to be searching for. And you don't look like the typical part scavenger type to me. I calculate a 98.8% chance that you're looking for the Mechanist. If I'm correct, and I usually am, then perhaps we can help each other with our respective predicaments.
I'm listening.
How refreshing. Then allow me to explain. Now, how can I put this as simple as possible so someone at your processing speed can understand? In order to find the Mechanist, you're going to need more than just my radar beacon. You're going to need access to the facility. I'm willing to provide said access, but you'll have to fulfill two simple conditions. One, you need to get me as far away as you can from these lunatics. And two, find me a new body. Once both conditions are satisfied, I'll gladly provide you with everything you need. Do we have a deal? Even though there's a human brain floating in a biogel inside my head, I'm still bound by my original programming. It pains me to admit it, but one of my directives states that I cannot lie. Ever. So, while I'm not the most charming robot you've ever encountered, the last thing I'm going to do is violate an agreement we've made. Now that we have that out of the way, do we have a deal? A wise decision. Once we're at our destination, I'll happily relinquish my radar beacon as a gesture of good faith. Now, I strongly suggest you stop loitering in the middle of a hostile location and get us both out of here at once.
Thank you. All right, Brain Box. Ivy wants me to find out what makes you tick. So let's get started.
There's no need for that. I'm certain we can discuss this rather unfortunate situation before it gets completely out of hand. Now, what exactly did this Ivy tell you to do?
Simple. She wants me to crack open that dome you have for a head and find out how your brain is connected to your circuits.
Perhaps I can be of assistance in that regard. After all, there isn't much else I can do now that you've removed my head from its chassis. How about we forge some sort of an accord just between the two of us?
What the hell is an accord? You talking about wires or something?
Right. I need to phrase this so even a dullard like you would understand. Let me put it this way. You need information that's going to make your boss happy. I want to keep my brain in one piece. Maybe we can cut a deal.
Fine. I'm listening.
I'll tell you everything I know about my own construction. All the bits that Ivy wants to hear. And I promise you, she won't be disappointed. In return, you keep those tools away from me and put me back onto my body. You get what you want, and I don't get dissected like some kind of a laboratory experiment. Do we have a deal?
Well, that would save me a lot of time. And Ivy doesn't like waiting. Tell you what, you start talking, and I'll stop drilling. After I tell Ivy everything, we'll see how happy she really
gets. Watch the tripwires.
But
I think
I'm gonna leave your
head in that
machine
for
now. Just in case you decide to get any smart ideas.
I mean, yeah, it's a deal.
Standing down.
You really are taking the path of most resistance here, aren't you?
Intruder detected. Beginning search.
Scanner's clear.
Playing games with me, huh?
When you turn up, you're dead.
Initiating search for hostile target.
Thank you.
Search complete. No hostiles detected. Standing down. Hostile target detected. To flee, you will be identified and sanctioned. Fugitive has been located. Commencing attack.
Based on my limited experience with you, I estimate a 65% chance of making it out of here. Not optimal. An increase in effort could have an impact on the odds. This is the one that ripped my head off. I demand we rip her head off. It's only fair.
Up.
Yes.
Here you go, Ada. The final radar beacon. I'll need that head back when you're done.
Of course. Shouldn't take but a moment. There you go. Still in one piece. I'm not sure why you want the head back. All we needed was its radar beacon. Besides, robo-brains are notorious for being, well, a real pain in the neck.
What else do you know about the Ada?
Quite simply, it's the first time General Atomics produced a successful union between organic matter and robotics. The brain is used both as a control unit and a data storage unit, which is far more efficient than using standard circuits. Unfortunately, there were a lot of programming issues with these robots, which caused them to be a bit, shall we say, unhinged. Hopefully, this particular robo-brain will have some of the answers that we've been seeking.
Sounds an awful lot like a synth.
Not at all. The RoboBrain was built with a very different design philosophy in mind. General Atomics' intent was to use the human brain to augment the robot's functions, primarily to accelerate the decision-making process. Free thought and individuality was never intended. These were expressly built like soldiers, to follow orders without question. The RoboBrain's unfortunate tendency towards violence and aggression should be considered more of a malfunction than a calculated decision.
Now that you have the final radar beacon, will it be enough to track down the mechanist's location?
I certainly hope so. I've already started the calculations while we've been having this conversation. That still doesn't explain why you need that head back.
We still need it, Ada. I believe it can help us access the Mechanist's facility.
Of course. It makes perfect sense that the Mechanist would not only keep its location a closely guarded secret, but would secure it against intrusion as well. I'm terribly sorry. I hadn't considered that possibility at all. I'm afraid when it comes to assisting humans, I'm not doing very well lately.
Don't be ridiculous. If it wasn't for you, we couldn't have gotten this far already.
That's kind of you to say. Ever since I let my friends die in that caravan, I feel like I've been failing in my duties. I chose the route we took the day we were attacked. Perhaps if I'd selected an alternate route, they'd still be alive. Sometimes I wish that Jackson had programmed me with my personality mode set permanently to disabled.
You shouldn't think that way. Your personality helps you think creatively.
I always considered my personality to be a burden, but I suppose I've been looking at it incorrectly. I really think I needed to hear that from someone else. Thank you. Now I've distracted you for long enough. I'll finish up my calculations while you deal with our new friend, Jezebel. Hopefully, she'll be able to grant us access to the Mechanist's facility and we can put an end to this nonsense once and for all.